Good morning to everybody. Today we will be discuss the microwave electronics in MSc Physics semester 3rd unit 2nd, and we are continuing the ferrites medium. Today the topic is the wave propagation characteristics in a ferrite medium. What happens when a microwave propagates in the ferrites medium? So for this one, let us consider the microwave propagation in an infinite magnetized ferrite medium, means its length is the infinite. Using Maxwell equations, we can solve the problems. The ferrite medium is placed in the static magnetic field H0. Then the direction of the propagation of the along the H0, the effective permittivity tensor, as we have calculated earlier, is given as this one, the Bx, By, Bz. Mu 1 minus j mu 2 0 j mu 2 mu 1 0 0 0 mu 0 hx hy hz plus h0, because here the external magnetic field is along the z axis, that's why the magnetizing field along the z axis is hz plus h0. Now solve this equations, so we can calculate bx equal to mu 1 h1 hx minus j mu 2 hy. Similarly, by equal to j mu 2 hx plus mu 1 hy. And last, bz equal to the mu 0 multiplied by the hz plus h0. Now, the using the Maxwell equations, del cross E equal to minus del B by del T. And here we have right del by del T equal to the minus iota omega, and that is the j omega. We can write similarly. So to solve this equations, you can write del Ez by del Y minus del Ey by del Z equal to minus j omega mu 1 hx minus j mu z hy plus 0. So this can converted into like this one, g minus j omega mu 1 hx plus omega mu 2 hy. Similar for the second, del Ex by del Z minus del Ez by del X equal to mu 2 omega Hx minus j omega mu 1 Hy. And the last, del Ex by dy by the del X minus del Ex by the del Y j omega mu 0 Hz. Here we have considered that the wave is propagated along the Z axis, so the variations along the X and Y directions is 0. So del by del X equal to 0 and the del by del Y equal to 0. Here we have used that the field is very like this one, e raised to power j omega t minus j beta z. So the equations, minus j beta minus e y equal to the minus j omega mu 1 h x minus omega mu 2 h y. And this can be converted by the eliminating the j. We can write beta e y equal to the minus omega mu 1 h x plus j omega mu 2 h y. And the second, beta Ex equal to j omega mu 2 Hx and plus the omega H1 mu 1 Hy. And the last, because the variation of these two is 0, so 0 equal to the Hz. Similarly, for the next del cross H, we can obtain the beta Hy equal to the omega epsilon Ex, beta Hx equal to minus omega epsilon Ey, and the last 0 Ez. By eliminating Hx, Hy in above equations, we can write beta square minus omega square mu 1 epsilon multiplied with the Ey equal to j omega square epsilon mu 2 Ex. And the second equations, beta square minus omega square mu 1 epsilon Ex equal to minus j omega square epsilon mu 2 Ey. Using the first equation, Ex equal to minus j omega square epsilon mu 2 Ey divided by beta square minus omega square mu 1 epsilon. Substituting the value of the Ex into the first equation, we can write beta square minus omega square mu 1 epsilon Ey equal to the j omega square epsilon mu 2 multiplied by the minus j omega square epsilon mu 2 beta square minus omega square mu 1 epsilon multiplied by the Ey. Divide by the Ey in both sides, we can obtain beta square minus omega square mu 1 epsilon square equal to the omega 4 epsilon square mu to square. Squaring root of these two sides, we can obtain beta square minus omega square mu 1 epsilon equal to plus minus omega square epsilon mu 2. So we can obtain the beta square equal to omega square epsilon multiplied by the mu 1 plus minus mu 2. So there are the two possible values of the beta. One is for positive and second is one for the negative. So beta positive equal to the plus minus omega multiplied by the root of the epsilon mu 1 plus mu 2, and the for beta negative plus minus omega root of the epsilon mu 1 minus mu 2. So using these two values, we can obtain the relations between the Ex and Ey. Ex equal to minus j omega square epsilon mu 2 Ey divided by omega square epsilon mu 1 plus mu 2 minus omega square mu 1 epsilon. So this provides Ex equal to minus j Ey. And the second, for the beta negative, we can obtain the Ex equal to minus, sorry, plus j iota Ey. So we can conclude the results. What happens? First, beta positive and beta negative are the two circular polarized plane waves having the Ex equal to Ey. Circular polarized because Ex equal to the Ey. And here that is the along the axis is a real quantity and along the y-axis is the imaginary quantity. And for plane wave, we can write for beta equal to beta positive, Ex lags behind the Ey. Piche chalta hai. Because Ex equal to minus iota Ey. And the phasor lags, E phasor lags moves in the clockwise directions. And for the beta equal to beta negative, Ex leads the Ey because we have right Ex equal to plus iota Ey. So E phasor moves in the counterclockwise directions or anticlockwise directions. Second conclusions, these two circular polarized wave may be considered as the fundamental mode of propagation in the ferrite medium. Since a linearly polarized wave can be considered the composed of the two circular polarized wave. As earlier in optics, we have constituted that a plane or the linear polarized wave is the combination of the two reverse circular polarized wave. So this is like this one. So if the plane wave is incident on this one, it will be converted into the two circular polarized waves moving in the opposite directions. So any plane wave propagating in the magnetized ferrite medium can be analyzed in terms of the fundamental modes characterized by the beta positive and beta negative. Third, the effective permeability for the two modes characterized by the beta positive and beta negative are denoted by the mu positive and mu negative. So mu positive equal to the mu 1 plus mu 2. And here the mu 1 equal to mu 0 1 plus omega 0 omega m divided by omega 0 square minus omega square. And similarly, mu 2 equal to the omega mu 0 omega omega 1 omega 0 square minus omega square. Substituting value of these two, we can obtain the mu positive equal to mu 0 multiplied by the omega 0 square minus omega square plus omega m divided by the omega 0 plus omega divided by omega 0 square minus omega square. And this gives provides rearrange kiya jaye to milta hame mu positive equal to mu 0 multiplied by the 1 plus omega m divided by omega 0 minus omega. And similarly for the mu negative, that is mu 1 minus mu 2. So this gives again the same values but in the different manners, and this gives like this one, the mu 0 multiplied by the 1 plus omega m divided by omega 0 plus omega. So what is the difference between these two? Is only the plus minus in the denominator of the second terms. This so the effective permeability for the two modes vary with the frequency omega. For the mu positive becomes 8. Omega equal to omega 0. What happens? Equation of the 18 when then it converted into infinite. So its sign is the omega equal to omega 0. It will be, and the it is called gyromagnetic resonance frequency. On the other hand, mu negative varies the monatomically from the mu 0 1 plus omega m by the omega 0 to the mu 0 as frequency vary from the 0 to infinity. So this can conclude that only one mode having the probability mu positive exists in the resonance behavior at omega equal to omega 0. So this is all about the propagation of the wave inside the ferrets medium. Thank you.
Thank you very much.